area. We have the Algonquins. They're in the Golden Lake area, in the Mississauga of Curve Lake to the south of us. This is the territories of the Anishinaabe. This is also in the Williams Treaty area. We are all treaty people here in Canada, and as such, it doesn't hurt for us to remind each other. These lands, the waters, the trees, the seeds, the birds, the bees, the two-legged, the four-legged, the swimmers, they were all cared for a millennium before the Europeans arrived here by the Anishinaabe. And we want to thank them for that. And hope you enjoy our program here at Tales from the Big Canoe. I've got a couple of really interesting interviews with some women artists that are going to bring their songs, their music, and their stories to our show today. So I hope you enjoy it. And I'm going to start right off with an interview with Sharon Blondin, and we'll get into her music. I'm going to break into the interview a little bit and play some of her music so you can hear her explanation of the songs. Larry O'Connor here, Tales from the Big Canoe, and I have Sharon Blondin with me today. Sharon, how are you doing?
I'm doing great. It's a beautiful day.
So, Sharon, where are you from?
I'm from Penetanguishene.
Now, I ran into you a half a dozen years ago in an arena at a Métis gathering.
Oh.
I'm not sure whether I'm in the right spot or not, but somehow or other, I've got your CD.
Yeah, I did hand a few out. I was in a few contests, and I did hand a few of them out.
It's called Medium Highlights.
Yeah, that was the first one I've recorded.
Okay, and it looks like a lot of family history in some of this listening.
Yes, there's a lot of personal lyrics to a lot of my first CD that I did, reflecting on my family members. Some of them were musically inclined, and some were just, you know, personal things about them that I remember. So I kind of always remembered most of my family as a song.
Well, that's a good way to remember them. Now, you're Métis. Your heritage is Métis?
Right.
And how did you discover your heritage?
Well, I was going through a rough time in my life. It was pretty sad. I was just always writing. I started writing at 15 years old. One time I was going through a rough time, and I had a dream that was pretty real, and I woke up crying. The dream was so real that I started to draw it one night at work when I had a break, and somebody was looking over my shoulder saying that it looked as though I was drawing the picture of the Catagua, which is a place in La Fontaine, Ontario, where the settlers were here baptizing the indigenous people. So it was like 5 years later, I actually was driving down this road and looked in my rearview mirror, and I saw the line of trees that looked so familiar, like in my dream. So I drove up that road, and at the end of the road was the crucifixes on a mount in the middle of a field, and it was exactly what I drew. So it was like 5 years later.
Wow, that's amazing.
So I applied for the... I did a CD. I was in the middle of doing my first CD, and I ended up sending it to Rock 95, and it turned out that I found out that I was Métis, and I was the first female to submit my CD, and she played it on the radio on late night Rock 95 called Spirit Wind.
Very good. Well, you're going to be played on Tales from the Big Canoe here at Canoe FM for sure. Now, that song about the dream, is that the one that's called The Girl?
Yes, that's the one.
That's the inspiration there.
The Girl was my biggest impact in my life, that one there, because it really spoke to me. And when I found the place, it was amazing when I got there that I couldn't believe it. And I even had when I went up to pray when I got there and to thank them for leading me there. The sky kind of opened up and I had a sun shower, which made it even more special. I did some research and it said that they held another mass on that site, and it was September 1965, which I was like, wow, that's the month and year I was born. And I was kind of really interested in it. So I found out that I was Métis. It really connected with me because I wasn't really spiritual at the time before that.
I hear the cries as she calls into my dream. A shower of tears as she begins to scream. Wish she did it all again. Could she be set free? Tell me why she calling out to me. Voices in the air, then she's no longer there. A face I've never seen in a place I've never.
To Tales from the Big Canoe, and I'm interviewing Sharon Blondin and asking her a little bit about her music. And this is a little excerpt going in from one song to another. Now, another point of inspiration there was one about your grandfather.
Right.
Tell me about that, please.
We always got together at my grandfather's house. He's always played the fiddle, you know, and my uncles played guitar. My mother used to play the accordion. And we all, you know, did the kitchen parties where everybody would step dance and things like that. You know, I just kind of always reflected back on that, how it always brought people together, always made people happy. And my grandfather, he just loved playing the fiddle. So I just wrote what I saw. And my father, grandfather, he worked hard all his life. He was the first person around our area to sell Christmas trees. He used to travel to the cities. He couldn't read any signs, but he knew the landmarks. So he was pretty big for that, and planting trees and cedars in the summer, and everybody kind of helped, you know, filling up the bags with the soil and things like that. And yeah, I just write a special song for him.
Would be yeah. Simon.
Well, in French, it would be Simeon. So yeah.
Amazing.
Grandpa's hands can tell the stories of how things used to be. How December nights got colder, working in behind the Christmas trees. You'd hear the crackle and the fall of another tree to hold. But when the working day would fall, his old fiddle came off the wall. And the fiddle sits on his shoulder. Another year he never gets much older. As his heels kick to the sky and the fiddle dances through his eyes, you leave time where it stands. For tonight he's a young man once again. For tonight he's a young man once again. Spent pulling cedar, no time for a breather. Lunchtime came at noon, a cold beer, then pretty soon he was back behind the wheel of the flatbed truck and the old dog at his heels. But the fiddle sits on his shoulder. Another year he never gets much older. As his heels kick to the sky and the fiddle dances through his eyes, he'll leave time where it stands. For tonight he's a young man once again. For tonight he's a young man once again. Sits at the window to watch a town and how it's grown. The kids are all much older and moved out on their own. Six kids and a wife, he never learned to read or write. But I guess you could say he made it. It was damn sure worth the fight. Cause a fiddle sits on his shoulder. Never get older. As his heels kick to the sky, still the fiddle dances through his eyes. He'll leave time where it stands. For tonight he's a young man once again. For tonight he's a young man once again. For tonight he's that young man once again.
And here's another description of her song, Summer Falls, by Sharon Blondin.
Summer Falls?
Yeah.
That one there, my uncle had fell between two boats just a few blocks from here on the bay, telling a joke, but he couldn't swim. So he, I guess a few people jumped in and they couldn't find him. So we searched for him for days. And he was going through a rough period in his life with divorce. And that was a song that really brought our family closer to each other, and it affected a lot of us when I first sang the song.
She was dreaming of someone to fill her thoughts through the day, through the day. He once was married. Start on their own, making their life.
close out with a last word here from Sharon Blondin, and I thank her for the time she spent with us today, and hope you've enjoyed her music as much as I have. Well, you've put your heart and soul into the CD, and appreciate that, and your time. So do you make a living at playing music?
No, I've sang at a contest. I've sang at Kemp and Fest, Star Search through Kix FM and things like that.
Right.
I was a finalist twice. Never really sang for money. I sang Ladybug Cafes and stuff like that.
Very good.
Yeah. I did an indigenous water walk, if
right.
you know what that
yes,
is.
Yes, yep.
So we did that a few years ago where we walked 20 kilometers with, it's like a preserving of water we
yes.
take from the bay, and we walk it to another source.
Well, I want to thank you for that. The water walkers are, they're found in, right across Turtle Island, more so all the time, and so I thank you for that. And we will put your song on the air here on Tales from the Bay Canoe, and thank you for sharing your personal stories with us today. Any closing thought?
No, I was just happy to do it, and thank you for asking.
All right. You have a great day.
You too. Take care.
Take care, my friend. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
So I hope you enjoyed that interview with Sharon Blondin. And you know what? We've ran the clock so long, it's time to take a break. So we better take a little break here. You're listening to Tales from the Big Canoe, and let's hear from our sponsors.